a final farewell to a New England icon. This morning, they'll also celebrate the legacy that Chet Curtis left behind.
The Eye Openers' John Atwater is at St. Cecilia's Parish in Boston, where people will gather in just a few hours, John.
And Antoinette, you know, Chet Curtis really influenced so many here in New England throughout his long career here in Boston. And today, hundreds will be here to celebrate his life.
You know, Chet's presence in our newsroom for all the years that I had the opportunity to work with him made me a better person. It made WCVB a better station, and I think the greater Boston area a much better place.
Former colleagues and friends who worked with Chet Curtis during his long 50 years in the business remember his remarkable life.
I knew him as a competitor, as a colleague, and as a friend over 30 years, and he was incomparable in all categories.
We loved him, and Natalie and Chet did a great job, and I enjoyed working with him at the telethon for 20-odd years.
At Chet's wake last night, hundreds arrived to pay their respects, including Senator Ed Markey and Secretary of State John Kerry.
Well, he was a class act and a great newsman, and, you know, he really set the standard. He and Natalie together sort of defined the newsroom for Massachusetts for years.
He was certainly a pro on camera, but friends say his most important legacy will be his children.
Those three daughters standing there, Lindsay, Dawn, and Dana, have been amazing through all of this, and they're amazing today.
And he really did have such a remarkable life, both on and off camera. The funeral begins here at St. Cecilia Parish at 11 o'clock this morning. We're live in Boston this morning. John Atwater, WCVB News Center 5.
And you can watch Chet's funeral this morning online at WCVB.com. We'll also stream the service on our WCVB mobile news app's coverage.